Something just to kind of, I don't know, music has been something we've shared since we've been together, and so I wanted to try to figure out a way to incorporate it beyond maybe what we've had this evening, which has been great. Just something between us, though, and initially I had thrown around some ideas of maybe doing like an Elvis song or something, just to kind of do a cover. Up until about 2 weeks ago, that was the plan, and right before I got, as I was kind of practicing and in my spare time doing some of that stuff, I ended up actually coming up and writing something. It started clicking for me, and so here we are. This is the song for you. So tonight is the night when I marry my fate, a girl who I met on a Bumble date, a girl who is now called my wife. Welcome to the rest of my life.
That's cool.
Quando me prend dans ses bras, elle me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Tu les jeux et ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. Ça lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans la vie.
Butterflies just thinking about getting to see how beautiful you are going to look when I see you walk down the aisle later this evening.
I cannot wait to walk down the aisle and see you standing there looking so handsome in your suit. I've dreamed of this day for a long time and I'm so honored that I get to share this with you.
I'm truly excited to spend a monumental day in my life with such a beautiful, kind, and intelligent woman such as you, Laura. The way you have been able to plan out this wedding to look and be the way that it is has been absolutely outstanding and just another reminder of why I have chosen you to be standing across from me today.
I've waited a long time to find someone like you to love and share my life with, and now we get to. You help me be the best version of myself and we make a great team. I love how we complement each other in our strengths and weaknesses.
Try your very best not to stress too much. Today is going to be perfect because it's the day that we are able to finally signify a bond that has grown over the last 3 years. Our family and friends are going to get to witness that, and that's great. Today is the first day of our new lives together. Let's bring them out, ha ha.
I'm so excited for the wonderful life we are going to build together. We are going to have so much laughter, adventure, and lots of dogs. I feel so supported and loved by you, and I know that we can get through anything together. I'm really excited to start our life together as husband and wife. I'm really excited to buy our first home together, have a family, and support you in whatever you might need. I still have to say that I'm not nervous to marry you. I know that you're my person. I'm so excited to tie the knot in front of our friends and family and start our new adventure together. Today, tomorrow, and forever, I choose you and I cannot wait to be your wife. I love you, Mark Stone, with all of my heart. Now let's do this. Love, your soon-to-be wife, Laura.
I cannot wait to see you this evening. I love you so very much, my soon-to-be wife, your husband, Mark.
It's sweet, isn't it? At least a week. At least a week. Wise men say, oh, but I
Because you've expressed a desire to unite in marriage and have made your commitment to one another public, I'm going to ask both of you to take your vows in the presence of your family. So Mark, please repeat this vow before God and all these witnesses. I, Mark,
receive you, Laura,
as my God-given wife. Now you were talking, I want you to listen real carefully.
Sir.
Mark, do you promise to love and cherish Laura, to communicate with, to respect and support her, to resolve conflict quickly, to forgive her when she makes a mistake, and seek her forgiveness when you make a mistake, to work hard in demonstrating these qualities on good and bad days, and to stand firm in your commitment to love Laura for life?
I do.
I wrote that myself after being married for a long time.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. Now, Laura, please repeat this vow before God and these witnesses. I, Laura. Receive you, Mark. As my God-given husband. Laura, do you promise to love and cherish Mark, to communicate with, to respect and support him, to resolve conflict quickly, to forgive him and when he makes a mistake, and seek his forgiveness when you make a mistake, to work hard in demonstrating these qualities on good and bad days, there'll be some of both, and to stand firm in your commitment to love Mark for life?
I do.
Mark, what do you give as a token of your love for Laura?
This ring.
Mark, throughout history, as you look at that ring, the ring has been used to seal important covenants. You will notice that this ring is a complete circle without beginning or end. It serves as a symbol of the endlessness of your love for Laura. Mark, take this ring and place it on the third finger of Laura's left hand. And as you place it, repeat after me. With this ring, I take you as my wife. And all I have. I give to you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, Laura, what do you give as a token of your love for Mark?
I give this ring.
Laura, you'll notice that the ring is made of the purest of metals. It will not turn or tarnish with age. It serves as a symbol of the purity of your love for Mark. Take this ring and place it on the third finger of Mark's left hand. And as you place it there, repeat after me. With this ring, I take you as my husband. And all I have.
I give to you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I now pronounce you husband and wife. But we've only just started. You're husband and wife now, but there's going to be other things this evening.
All right, Laura, so we're getting married. Mm-hmm. That's pretty cool, yeah? I knew before I even had an opportunity to officially meet you in person that there was something special about you. The evening of our first date, per our luck, it obviously had a downpour as we were driving to meet up in Dallas. Since you lived in Arlington and of course I lived in Frisco, I had a split second consideration of wanting to reschedule after how bad it had started raining just to get there. And you remember my call, of course?
Yep.
We hadn't even had to officially like hurt each other's voices yet. And I just kind of went in just trying to kind of feel you out and consider what my answer was going to be and maybe if I should cancel or just play by ear, I guess. Since we both know how much a waste of time an online dating app date can actually be. The moment we spoke though, I could already sense like all of your sincerity. you immediately gave me an answer that I was looking for and obviously I win. after almost canceling that first date, we ended up having a crazy date that was like how long? 8 hours or something crazy, I think. Now over 3 years later, I can genuinely say that it was the smartest decision I ever made to decide to tough out the storm and actually meet you. From my best and first, or my best and my favorite first date, and everything amazing and not so amazing, COVID maybe, we've shared in between. It has all led me up to this moment when I can officially finally call you my wife. It's an honor that I vow to always cherish deep in my heart. I vow to encourage your compassion because this is what makes you unique and beautiful. I vow to appreciate you, all that you do for me and everyone in your life because the world needs more selfless people like you in it. I vow to always be your partner, teammate, and best friend. Sorry, Saris. because there's nothing that you and I can't tackle together. I vow to always remember why I chose to be standing here with you today, no matter what obstacles we face, because you're my person and I'm yours. This is my sacred vow to you, my equal in all things.
I can't believe I'm standing in front of my best friend about to be married. There are many reasons why I know you are my person. Some of those include how you love my family, you love my dog, and you love shoes. It only took 3 dates for me to know that I love you. You standing in a Walmart parking lot in your socks so that I wouldn't be the only one without shoes was just the beginning. Ever since then, I have only been able to see more deeply how sweet and caring you are. You inspire me to be the best version of myself, and you support me when I'm having a hard time. You always know how to make me laugh and to see the positive in difficult situations. You are able to do all of the tasks that I find impossible, such as operating electronics and pulling bugs. But the thing that never ceases to amaze me about you is how genuine and loving you are. As your wife, here are the promises that I make to you today. I vow to always be truthful and honest with you. I vow to never give up on us, even through ups and downs. I vow to always put you first and never lose sight of how much you mean to me. I vow to tolerate your fanny pack if you tolerate my candle collection. I vow to be patient and to love you unconditionally, even when you are wearing said fanny pack. I vow to listen when you talk and to be the partner that you deserve. I vow to say I'm sorry and admit when I am wrong. And lastly, I vow to never stop laughing with you, to be your best friend, and to love you forever.
Dear God, we come humbly to you today, asking you to bless this family, that they would be people who would remember you and look to you for strength, for wisdom, for courage, for direction as they go together through life's way. Might your way be their way. We ask that they might always experience your love and grace, that they will know and exhibit kindness and gentleness as you would have them to do. God, there are many of us who will walk with this family and love them. We ask that we too may know your love and that we might walk in your ways, that you will light that way and help us to look to you as our guide. We here today will walk alongside of Mark and Laura. We commit our love and support to them and will encourage them as we do life together. We give thanks to you today and we rejoice together in one another. Amen. One final thing, it says here. May God bless your lives with the love that only He can give. Mark, you may now kiss your wife.
Congratulations.
Let's have a look at Mark Bell.
Oh, you're so good.
want to say, Mark, we're really, really excited to have you as part of the family. It feels like you've been part of the family for the last 3 years. So tonight is just nothing short of just a formality in my book. But we're really grateful to you. I've always wanted nothing more than somebody to just love my sister and treat her the way she deserved to be treated. And you fit all of that and more. And that makes me love you, too. So for that, welcome to the family. We love you. We're happy to have you. Laura, congratulations. I'm so glad you found your man.
Hi, everybody. As Laura's mother, I just want to say we've been praying for our baby girl all her life to have the perfect husband. And Mark, we've been praying for you since you were a little baby and you didn't even know it, did you? But you're perfect for Laura. You're perfect for our family, and we love you so much. Love you.
Hey. Good.
Thank you, baby.
We love you.
I just wanted to tell you that he's everything I've been praying for years. Thank you.
He fixes all of that. I mean, I try not to bother him. After about an hour and a half, I'm like, okay, I'm just going to have to call Mark. He comes over and goes, okay, there you go. And I'm like, oh, my God. And then I just want each of you to know, if you have not had Laura cook for you, this woman needs to open a restaurant or a catering company because she can cook better than any restaurant.
I'm back and not ashamed to cry.
Longer than that.
Yeah.
People who supported us in our relationship and fostered us to this point.
3 years running at this point.
Mm-hmm. And our family support and support for the marriage and the wedding and everything that goes into that. And we're so excited and relieved that we've made it to this day and we're married now and we get to go forward and start our lives as an official family with our two fur babies and maybe one day a human baby.
Let's see what happens.
But we just appreciate everybody's love and support, and we feel very fortunate and very loved and very supported, I think, in a lot of ways. So
genuinely, thank you all for coming tonight. It was greatly appreciated to have y'all all out here.
giving us support, moral support. It was something that was really beautiful to be able to share with everybody. So genuinely thank you all for coming tonight and being able to share this special moment with us.
Yes.
Yes.
All right. We did it. We're married.
Yes, we're married.